Today I would like to speak about membrane perforation during your, I think, everyone plays implant in our patient. Sometimes perforate membrane on our sinus. That's why I found out an interesting way to solve this problem. First of all, membrane perforation, is it a strategy for you? Or for me, now it's not. I think no. But all of us use ultra short implant in our practice. But sometimes you need to use external sinus lift. And in fatigued persons, in these cases, you can perforate sinus membrane. If it's not so large, less than 5 millimeters, you can suture it or maybe just move it around your window. But sometimes during that time, to suture or move it, perforation increases. That's why you can just say, oh, I'm sorry, mission failed. But I think that there is a way to solve this problem. First of all, you clean up your bone window, move the membrane around bone window, and just wait for bleeding. If you see that there is enough blood, you can use resorbable membrane size so that it covers the window up to 3 millimeter or more. Put resorbable membrane upon the window and after that just suture. For this part it's enough. After that you need to know how long membrane resorbs. You need to wait half of the resorption period. Example, if resorption period of your membrane is 6 months, you need to wait 3 and after that you go to the next part and open the window and you see the scar tissue and small resorbable membrane inclusions. It separates easily, moves easily, and now you can use external sinus lift in any way you like. This is my passion, just bragging. This is a patent for this. You can use it by free. You don't need to pay here. In Russia, you must pay a lot of money to use this way to solve the problem with membrane perforation. But usually, we need to use the internal sinus lift. And I hope always to do it like this. Then the membrane is great, it's a good, the membrane is very good, it's easy to move, and there is no perforation. But I need to say that it's not often. Because I work in Moscow, there's too many cars, and ecological situation is not so good. That's why membrane is thin, but it's always thin. And it's not the only one, but the second one, and the triple one. And here we see perforation after extraction. This is one, it's just collagen and hydroxyl apatite. We just mix it with blood, put it inside the socket, and after that the same. Now, you see this?
Here,
after 3 years, you have enough bone inside. Here we see the perforation, the material is inside the sinus, inside the sinus. But after 3 years of loading, we have no inflammation inside the sinus. The same case Here we have perforation. Here, you see, and after 3 years, there's no inflammation inside the sinus, it's not bone, and this looks like everything working, and that's that. Since for 10 years, I placed more than 500 Bicon implants, more than 2,500 implants placed in upper jaw. More than 200 implants placed with internal sinus lift. I not so often use external sinus lift. Usually I use internal sinus lift. Nearly 1,000 implants placed with a sinus membrane perforation. 20 implants were lost, a period from 3 months to 24 months after placement. Not after loading, after placement. All others are still work till nowadays. I hope it was useful for you. Thank you.